Oh, I am ready for the storm. Yes, so ready, I am ready for the storm. I'm ready for the storm.
Hey folks, welcome to the Okie Prepper channel. You know, when I started my YouTube adventure out some months ago, I began with a video on water purification. I did some research, figured out how to clean the water, disinfect it, store it, such. And really what I was doing was an experiment to see how long I could store water before bacteria grew or algae grew or thereof. And so far, this is going to be the 40-week update on water purification, and it's December probably 23rd, and as you can see, tank looks pretty good. I got the light shining on it, and so you can see that there's no bacteria growing in it yet. And I want to make a note that that is the original water that I put in from the first video, and there has not been any additional chlorine in it. I haven't had to fill it since the second video, the 20-week video. I put that water in and I haven't added it to it, and there has been absolutely no evaporation that I can tell. So this is a good stock tank if you're looking for one. Check out the box, probably a link in there for you. I know I've had a lot of requests on where I got it. You know, one thing that I would add to that list of do's and don'ts before drinking the water would probably be to run this water through a Purification filter before you consume it. I know in the directions we stated that you should allow the water to sit in an open container for 3 to 4 hours so that the chlorine escapes, as it does as a gas. And I would do that too, and then I would run the water through a Purification filter just to make sure that there was just no any kind of chlorinated water left in there, chemical whatsoever. It would be safe and I'd feel a lot comfortable drinking that water. But in an emergency situation, this is all you had, you're still safe. I guess on the short term, I should say. So in this video, I'm going to, again, we're going to pour some out, look at the clarity. Then we'll go up top and drop the camera down the tank so you can see how clear it is and how good a job that the stock chlorine actually is doing. All right, well, let's go from there. Okay, now I'm going to pour out a little bit of this treated water. We're going to check the clarity and the taste. I'm going to pour out the first portion. I know there might be some dirt or dust in that PVC pipe. You know, before I poured it into a glass jar, didn't I?
Okay, that's good.
How's that look to you? Get you a drink of that, huh? All right. Okay, here we are at the top of the tank. And I got a little bit of light shine on the tank just so it's more illuminated. It's kind of late in the day, as you can see, late December day. So I don't have much sunlight to make the tank glow for you. So I'm hoping that this light will do. And you can see I'm taking the lid off. And got some cellophane up here. Kind of works just to help seal some of the air. It does have a check valve in the top of that lid, but this kind of cellophane helps prevent the evaporation process. I did clean off the top there for you. so make sure we don't got any of that going in there. Let's do the deed here. I love this part. All right, you can see no particles, no algae growth. Clean all the way to the bottom. I'm gonna shake it so you can see it. There we go. Still clear and as clean as the day I put it in there. You know, I don't have the best nose for this. As far as smelling the amount of chlorine that's in there, I don't really detect any. So I better go get a second opinion. In fact, I'm gonna get two second opinions. We'll hit up Geronimo and Raindrop and see what they say. All right.
We're going mobile. Get this thing loose here.
All right, we're mobile.
Have to find our would-be candidates.
All right. Oh, look at that.
Yeah, you know what time of year it is. The prepper's wife made those.
That's right. Oh, here we have a candidate. And y'all know Raindrop. Raindrop, we're smelling for chlorine.
Okay.
Get you a good whiff of that and see if it smells funny.
Nope.
It
smells like water.
Let's find another candidate. Geronimo!
I'm right here.
Hey. Alright, come in here and light. We're doing a water taste test. Or smell test, excuse me. Smell anything funny about that water?
A little bit.
Go ahead, get you a sniff.
Not much.
Okay. Let's ask the prepper's wife.
No! Smells clean.
Okay. So, we did a smell test. Nobody smelled anything funny. So, good chance a lot of our chlorine may have evaporated out of there, and even so, still very clear, still very clean, no algae. That's the biggest test. So it's probably just enough parts per billion to keep this water clean. There would have to be, or it would have a lot of algae, because that tank partially sits exposed to the sun with that window above it. So, and from my experience with aquariums, I can tell you it's definitely something that would cause algae to grow. Okay, we're gonna let this sit here for 3 to 4 hours. Let it breathe, and then we'll give her a drink. All right. Okay, it's been about 3 hours. We're gonna aerate the water and take a swig. This is supposed to help take out the flat taste. I would imagine it also helps the residual chlorine in there escape as well. You know, water gets flat after it sits for a while. It may get a little, you know, foul taste to it. This will help re-aerate, reintroduce oxygen into the water. Pick up that flat taste. Alright, bottoms up. Tastes like it just came out of the tap. It's nice and clear, doesn't smell, tastes fine. Tastes great. Well, I'd say so far this experiment with the stock chlorine's been a success. If there's anybody else out there doing videos and maybe purifying water with chlorine, video response would be cool. You know, let me know what your experience and has been with that. All right, well, we'll do another one of those in about 20 weeks, see where the water's at. I'm pretty impressed with the whole experiment this far because, you know, I was expecting there to be some algae growth on there. Because, like, again, I haven't added any chlorine to the water since, you know, day one. So this is going to be good for the future when we're wanting to store some water in a tank. We know we can just put a little stock chlorine in there and it's going to stay good. You know, close this video out. I'm just going to say thank you for subscribing and watching and these videos and, you know, I noticed there's not a whole lot of rating going on my videos, so there's a little thumbs up icon down there somewhere. Click on that if you like the video. Kind of lets me know, you know, what people are thinking. There's not a lot of comment going on my channel, and that's cool. Yeah, I'd like to give a little shout out to, you know, some of my other prepper buddies out there. You know, there's a guy kind of new on the scenes, Southern Prepper One. He's doing some really good videos, very interesting stuff, very informative stuff. So if you have a chance, check out his channel. And you know, I got a list there on my main page there about channels that I like, and you know, you may see channels come and go off there, and you know, that's nothing big or nothing personal or anything like that. I just change them out every now and then, just kind of keep it fresh. And in fact, the other day I checked on there and all of them had been wiped out, and all my favorites were gone, and I had to put them all back on there. So if you discover your name is not on there now, that's why. And I just forgot who all was on there. You know, I'm just putting them on there to, you know, help them get their channels built up and get some exposure, but not a big deal. Southern Prepper again, Southern Prepper One, good channel visit. Mountain Prepper, he's doing a good job. He's like me, he's just starting out with his channel, and we're just trying to, you know, have fun with this and experiment, and mainly just kind of keep a dialogue going between us and other folks out here. Pine Tar 100, that guy, and he's doing an outstanding job. He's busy loading up videos, you know, a couple a week, just doing projects around the house with his chickens and his gardening and his co-frames, which I'm really interested in getting to that. Put my house on the market a couple of months ago to basically get out of the small town out to the country where I had some bigger and better farming land, and I actually got a contract on my house right now, and I'm hoping that doesn't fall through. But as soon as that takes place, Okie Prepper's moving to the farm, so to speak. Again, thank you for watching the videos, subscribing, and you know, it's the holiday season, so from my family to yours, have a Merry Christmas and a safe and Happy New Year. All right, thanks for watching.